Hello everyone, welcome you all in my new video. In this video I am going to solve few MCQ which is based on general geology and geophysics. So our first problem is a primary wave reflected from the Gutenberg discontinuity is denoted by. So this will be from the figure. You can see here, this is the boundary between mantle and outer core, and from this boundary, which is known as in terms of discontinuity, is Gutenberg discontinuity, and the phases P small c P, which is reflected from the Gutenberg discontinuity. So our option A, which is correct for the given problem, and we can also see the other option. The second one is PKP. So in the figure you can see PKP, PKP. So PKP is traversing through outer core. Third option is PKIKP. So here this is our third option, which is goes from focus to outer core to inner core, again outer core, then mantle, then seismic station. So PKIKP, and last one is PK small IKP, which will reflected from the outer core and inner core boundary. Here you can see this and this phase. So PKP, PK small IKP, which is reflected from outer core and inner core boundary. So our option A will correct, that is a primary wave reflected from the Gutenberg discontinuity is denoted by PCP. Next problem is the intensity of the Earth's magnetic field at the equator in gamma is at equator. The magnetic field is 30,000 nanotesla, that is one nanotesla is gamma. So at equator the value is 30,000, and at pole the value will be 60,000. That is, so the answer will be B, 30,000. Next is seismic phases which are recorded in the shadow zone. So here we have to find out the seismic phases which is recorded in shadow zone. So our option D, PKKP, as I already told you in first problem, this is PKKP, which is traversing through only outer core, which is not going in inner core. So this will be our option. Next is the primary wave velocity is maximum in the, so the from the figure, this is the velocity profile. So in the lower mantle, primary wave velocity, that is alpha, which is maximum. So our option upper mantle will be, sorry, lower mantle will be correct one. So option C will be correct. Next question is, what is a pycnocline? So pycnocline is basically a layer of ocean water in which water density increases rapidly with depth. So option B, a zone of rapidly changing density will be correct. Next question is, the Adams-Williamson equation is utilized for modeling the variation of following with depth inside the earth. So basically एडम्स विलियम्सन इक्वेशन विच इज़ गिवन बाई डी पी बाई डी आर इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस रो आर जी आर, वे आर जी आर इज़ द ग्रेविटी, रो आर इज़ द डेंसिटी, पी इज़ द प्रेशर एंड आर इज़ द रेडियस. सो आवर आंसर विल बी सी एंड दैट इज डेंसिटी, डेंसिटी वेरिएशन. ऑप्शन सी विल बी करेक्ट. द प्राइमरी सर्कुलेशन ऑफ एयर टू लो प्रेशर एरियाज काजिंग इट टू फ्लो नियरली पैरेलल टू द आइसोबार इज ड्यू टू, सो द ऑप्शन विल बी कोरियोलिस फोर्स. नेक्स्ट वन इज इफ अ प्लैनेट रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड द सन इन अ पीरियड ऑफ 8 ईयर देन द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सन विल बी, सपोज टी इज द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सन टू अर्थ, डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सन टू अर्थ, डी वन डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सन टू प्लैनेट. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ डी वन इन टर्म्स ऑफ डी, एंड सपोज टी इज द टाइम पीरियड, वन ईयर दैट इज फॉर अर्थ एंड टी वन विच इज इक्वल्स टू 8 ईयर्स टाइम पीरियड फॉर प्लैनेट. सो फ्रॉम कैपलर्स थर्ड लॉ टी वन स्क्वायर अपॉन फ्रॉम कैपलर्स थर्ड लॉ टी स्क्वायर दैट इज टाइम पीरियड इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ टाइम पीरियड विज प्रोपोर्शनल टू सेमी मेजर एक्सिस पावर 3. सो फॉर 2 टी अपॉन टी वन स्क्वायर विल बी इक्वल टू ए डी अपॉन डी वन होल क्यूब, वेयर डी इज द डिस्टेंस एंड हियर ए इज ऑल्सो डिस्टेंस. सो टी विल बी 1 एंड टी वन विल बी 8 की पावर 2 विच इज इक्वल्स टू डी ओवर डी वन होल क्यूब. सो 1/64 दैट इज 8 का स्क्वायर विल बी 64 डी क्यूब बाई डी वन क्यूब, और 1/4 इक्वल टू डी ओवर डी वन, डी वन विल बी 40 दैट इज 4 टाइम्स द अर्थ डिस्टेंस, वेर डी इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन अर्थ एंड प्लैनेट and d1 is equals to 4 into d. so our option b will be correct. Next is if the density of a given layer within the earth's interior is 4900 kilogram per meter cube, so density is 4900 kilogram per meter cube vp, that is primary velocity is 12 kilometer per second and Vs is 6.8 kilometer per second. So we have to find out K, that is bulk modulus. So Vp square minus 4/3 Vs square is equals to K over rho. As you know, Vp square is equals to K plus 4/3 mu by rho, and Vs square is mu upon rho. So from 1 and 2, this will get, this expression we will get from equation number 1 and 2. So Vp is given 12 square minus 4/3, Vs is given 6.8 square, which is equals to K डिवाइडेड बाई 4900. सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस वी विल गेट के इज इक्वल्स टू 403498. सो आवर ऑप्शन डी विच इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ इन एज इन क्वेश्चन गिवन दैट 1 GPA is equals to 10 kilobars. So in the question, 1 GPA is equals to 10 kilobar. So K will be this is in bar. So in kilobar is 4034.98. Sorry. So our option K will be nearly equal to 4 in terms of bar K is equal in terms of GPA K will be nearly about 403.498 GPA. So our option D will correct. Here you will convert the unit, you will get this option will correct. So next problem is the velocity of primary wave is minimum in. So the velocity of primary wave in the given figure is minimum in the outer core. Next is the axis through the geomagnetic poles is inclined to the earth axis at an angle of. So from the figure you can see this is 11.5 degree. So option C will correct. Next is which of the following gravity correction is always positive. So as you know terrain correction is always positive. So answer will be terrain correction. Next is intensity of an earthquake is a measure of. So intensity of an earthquake is a measure of degree of destruction. So our option B will be correct. So thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel.